we're going to learn how to make this inside ZBrush. Hey, my name is Marlon. First of all, download the ZBrush alphas. You can find the download link under the same video. Now, subscribe to the channel and let's jump into the video.
So this is the thing. I'm going to load my layer brush. Layer brush, and I already have one of my alphas already imported. Just to let you know, in this case, I created a bunch of alphas for this project that you're going to find on your download. You have different versions, and also you have versions of a version. So for example, for version 2, you're going to find 2B, 2C. You're going to find a bunch of different versions. So I kind of make sure that I don't need even to tweak the alphas later on when I'm implementing them, but just dragging and drop. Okay? So I'm going to drag, for example, the alpha number 1 that I created here. I think I have enough subdivisions. Let's put 5. Okay. So this is like the alpha, how it works by default. All right? I already sculpted each of them individually, so you get like a very nice detail, and also it doesn't inflate around the edges, but it just goes perfect. So what is the problem? The thing is that in every scale you're going to find like a little border that you need to respect from every alpha that you're creating. So by the time I drag a different alpha, what is going to happen is that it's going to interpolate. So it's pretty much going to get on top of the other one. So what I want to do is try to make sure that no matter how I'm dragging and dropping the alphas, but I also respecting the borders. So one of the cool things about ZBrush is about some of the brushes have like a double function. So in this case, if I have my layer brush on, and if I have my morph target stored with a default, by the time I drag one alpha and I drag the second one, what is going to happen is that it's going to respect that border, and I'm going to get like a new border. And this is fantastic because in this case I can literally drag and drop different versions of alphas, and still I'm going to get this border. Doesn't matter how many alphas I'm going to do, it's going to always respect it. So I just need to keep loading different alphas. Some alphas have different intensity, just to let you know. So I can keep loading different alphas, and still the border is going to stay there. So if you take this in consideration, you can create very nice detail and sharp detail across the character. So I'm going to load now my base mesh. In this case, the base mesh was created by Rafa Zavala. He's an excellent character artist. Make sure you check out his work. So the most important is try to analyze the flow of the character. So we can tell like you have like a very round, big alphas, well, big scales around the eyes. They start decreasing the size down. And from there, when you have like in this second shape from the orbicularis, from the eye area, they start going smaller and smaller. And then back again, they start getting bigger, and also they start getting a bunch of different paths. They don't go in this circular shape. But the most important is that, again, if you store the morph target from the beginning, by the time you are dragging and dropping different alphas, let's start with number one, for example. Make sure you're working always on layers. Your ZBrush file is going to be very high, but still, you're going to need this layer later on. I will show you. So we start doing all these big alphas, like big scales from the beginning. And it's fantastic because, as you can tell, I mean, we are still maintaining all the borders around the eye. Okay? And if you do it right, you can even get like a very nice sharp edges in some cases. Okay, so once you have all the alphas implemented, there is more work to do, of course. So ideally, you can even sharpen more your details. So here I have all my scales work out in one layer. On the next layer, what I'm going to do is to sharpen through layer inversion. So what I'm going to do, I'm going just to smooth out some of the areas where I feel the detail should be sharp. So it's pretty much all around the character, to be fair. So I'm going to sharp some of the areas so you can tell the difference. I'm going to leave some of the areas without being smoothed out so you can tell more the difference, okay? And the big trick here is, like, once you have everything smoothed out, just have to make a masking version, okay? So here under layers, you have one button that is called invert. And what it's going to do is just pretty much make the opposite operation. So this is quite relevant for this kind of job, because at the end of the day, you will need to make like cavity maps and a whole bunch of different maps, also the normal maps, to be able to create all the textures. And you need very sharp details in those areas. So by doing this mask inversion, you're going to find that your final texture inputs, they are sharper. So here is pretty much a quick example that how I did it. So in this case, I had the scales. I dropped down the number to 0.85, probably to make it a bit more smooth before applying the sharpen. Then I apply the sharp, which you can tell is quite strong. So what I did, I used the morph target to kind of restore some of the main forms from that previously the lizard had, and finally do some fixes on top. So with all these fixes on top, I could get more in detail about how the lizard should look like. Okay, I really recommend you to go through all the alphas that I have created, really analyze them, try to investigate which one is the best one, even try to create your own alphas. And from there on, just train to enjoy and make sure that you are able to create your own reptiles or your own animals easier with all these tips. Okay, thank you guys.
So it's pretty easy, isn't it? Don't forget to give me your thoughts on the comments, and see you in the next video.